Hello everyone, how you doing? It's Bill with the Vonniverse. In this video, I'm going to do a thread response for Robert C. It's his fourth in a series of threads that he's put out there. I did answer the first two. I skipped on the third one, or I should say I'm still sitting on the third one because I can't figure it out. The first thread was a song that you're just absolutely sick of, and if you don't want to ever hear it again. So I answered that one. The second thread was if you had the opportunity to rehear an album for the first time all over again, what would that be? That was a fun one. And then the third one, which I haven't gotten to yet, is a theme song for your YouTube channel. So I still haven't figured that out. Maybe someday I'll get to it when I figure out what that theme song would be. And then this is the fourth thread, which is Robert asked, what is your process for incoming records or items? So you buy a record, or you your process of when you buy a record or get a record into your house, what's your process? What do you do? So, I do have a process. I try to stick to it. And I'll go through each thing step by step. I don't know if other people do the same. We all have our own processes, and I'm sure most of us do very similar things, but this is what I do. This works for me. So there's two things, I guess, when I buy a brand new record and when I buy a used record or get a used record. They both follow similar processes, but getting a new record is slightly different. So when I get a record, regardless if it's new or used, I always clean it in some way. I always, depending on what the inner sleeve is for that album, if it's not a nice polylined sleeve, I'll replace that and put in a polylined sleeve, put a nice outer sleeve on it, catalog it, listen to it, and file it away. So for new records, step back. For all records, when I buy something new, the first thing that I do is I enter the information into Discogs. I try to find the exact release that it is, look in the Dead Wax and all the things you can look up for it. Try to make sure it's the exact item I have and log that in my Discogs page. I also keep a numbers spreadsheet with a database of my collection. So I log all the information that's pretty much in Discogs, pressing year, artist, title, catalog number, pressing year, the original release year, but then I also put in things like the date I cleaned it, or where I purchased it from, the date I purchased it, and any other special notes that I want to keep track of, I keep in that spreadsheet. Some of that information is also in Discogs, but I like to have it in my spreadsheet as well. So that's the first thing I do, is I catalog what I've picked up. So then I clean them. So if I get a new record, what I'll typically do is use a disc washer. So this is just the velvet pad that you put the solution on. Run it on the record, the solution wets it, cleans it, and then you slowly rotate the pad to dry it and get up all the debris. So typically that's what I'll do with new records. If you aren't familiar with the disc washer, it has an hour here, so you're always cleaning it in the same direction. It comes with a brush that you can get off any of the dust or anything that's accumulated on here. And then, of course, it has the solution. So I find that that typically does a good job for brand new records. If I look at the record and I see that it has fingerprints on it, or something that I don't think this disc washer will pick up, then I'll go through my other process. What is that other process? So for used records, I usually have a cleaning session where I'll do, 10, 15 records or so. Back when I got back into buying vinyl, going through all my catalog, I'd have these sessions that I do, 30 or 40 records at a time, and that was grueling, but it needed to be done. So what do I do for these used records? I have a cleaning solution that I'm very happy with. I don't know if anyone's familiar with this, but it's the Groovinator. It's a solution, concentrated solution, record cleaning solution. I've tried several. I do have a Spin Clean, so I used that solution for a while. I've tried Homemade, and this is the one that I like the most. I've had the most success with. I don't know if people may disagree with me. There's no alcohol in it. So it's completely safe for the vinyl, and like I said, I have had great success with it. So I have a special spray bottle record cleaner. You can see. So first thing I do is I have a Homemade DIY label protector. I saw this long time ago from Chris over at Dixieland Farm. He went step by step on how to make it, so I followed his steps, went through, and this does a pretty good job. So this protects the label. I'd say it's not 100% perfect. Occasionally there are some leaks. But it does a pretty good job. If any solution does get through, I'm sure enough to quickly wipe it down after I take this off. Make sure there's nothing accumulating on the label. So put the record in here. Spray the record. Sometimes I'll let it sit for a minute or two. Other times, if I don't have a lot of time to clean, I'll just immediately start scrubbing with a typical paint applicator here. I find that this works really well. Soft bristles here, and I scrub the record. Usually just going in a circle, following the grooves. I go both directions until I feel like it's, enough. Then I flip the record over, do the other side, spray, either let it sit or just start scrubbing. Then once it's done, I may let it sit some more. And then I have a little container that I keep a washcloth soaking in distilled water. And I'll wipe down one side, flip it over, wipe down the other side. Then I'll take the record out of this label protector, and I will do a rinse in my Spin Clean that just has distilled water in it with the scrubbing pads inside. Then once I spin it several times, take the record out of the Spin Clean and, pardon me, take the record out of the Spin Clean and put it in my rack to let air dry. And that process for me has been working really well. I like that. The air drying especially, I found, has reduced static issues quite a bit. Distilled water, rinsing the Groovinator solution, the diluted solution that I have, rinsing with the distilled water, I think is a necessary step to get any of that solution off, and then rinsing in the Spin Clean in distilled water is the final step, and then I let it air dry. Once it air dries, if I find any drops or anything, I'll take a microfiber cloth and I'll just lightly wipe them off and then let it dry completely. So for a single album, you know, it may take, including the drying process, it may take an hour or more. Now, that's mainly what I use, but I also do use scrubbing bubbles. If I find, say, a thrift store find that's exceptionally dusty, dirty, I may do the same exact process, but with scrubbing bubbles first. I'll use a totally separate pad for that. Do the scrubbing bubbles, rinse, and then I may go back and rinse or wash with the Groovinator solution after the scrubbing bubbles. But sometimes I'll just try scrubbing bubbles and see how good that has worked, and should be good. You know, usually is good to go. So after records are dry, I put in a nice sleeve. Now, there's several that I do like. I'm a big fan of these Disc Keeper sleeves. They do have a kind that is very close to the MoFi. I think they're actually a little bit more sturdy. So I like them a little bit more. I don't know if they're better or if MoFi is better, but this is my preferred. I also use just a plain polyline sleeve here. If a record may be VG or so, and it's not maybe a placeholder or not in the best condition, I'll probably put it in this sleeve and save the better sleeves for the better vinyl. I also like to use, also from Disc Keeper, these paper polyline sleeves. I don't see people mention these much about replacing in these, this type of sleeve, but I do like these. You can't see the record like you can with the other two sleeves, but this is nice and sturdy. Record slides in and out real nice, and it's, obviously it's lined. So after you do the inner sleeves, I also look at the album jacket, the album cover, and if it needs it, I will wipe the cover with a disinfectant wipe. Especially the glossy type of covers, these work really, really well. You're amazed when you start rubbing and you see the dirt come up off the album, the cover. Does a really good job. I forgot to mention one thing, so I had to come back and add this into the video. When I'm cleaning the sleeve, if there's any kind of sticker or anything on it that I think I can remove. I use this solution called Undo, and I've had pretty good success with this. So it comes with a self scraper here where you pour the solution onto the sticker, onto the label. So if it's a price sticker or what have you, something you don't want on there, pour this on there, let it saturate, and then slowly work it up with this little, I don't know what you call this, little scraper, I guess. And it does a really good job if the solution can get in there. Sometimes I guess there's stickers that you know, just know that you shouldn't mess with. But I find that this works pretty well. It's called Undo, and doesn't leave any stains or anything on the album jacket. When you put it on, you'll see that it gets wet, but it does evaporate very quickly. But it has some sort of property in there that lifts up the stickiness of the sticker and allows you to slowly scrape it off. Works really well. So, forgot to mention that. The jacket is cleaned, of course, place in a nice outer sleeve. So I do use Blake sleeves, and I also do use this Disc Keeper has outer sleeves as well that I like. I find these Blake sleeves to be a little tight for some albums, so I always have some other on hand in case it's too tight a fit. I do like the Blake sleeves because of the clarity. Let's see. Then once everything's cleaned, sleeved, I'll set aside here and I'll keep a listening pile of records that I've recently cleaned, and I'll get through them, listen to them, have a rotation of listening to them. Once they are cleaned, I'll go back to my spreadsheet and I'll log the date I cleaned them on, just to keep track. I should also mention when I get a new record in, used or new, in my spreadsheet, in my column that shows me when I clean the albums, after I log in the information, I'll put an A, B, or C or something in that cell to kind of order the records I want to clean first. So an A, if I sort it, the albums I want to clean first will be under A, and then if there's other albums that, like, I'm not too anxious to listen to right away, I might put a B or C or something, and then I have a cleaning order that I'll go through. This stack will get cleaned first, and then another group. So yeah, once they're all clean, sleeved, I put them aside here, and then one by one I'll listen to them as I can get to them. Then once I've listened to them and I'm ready to file them away, I'll file them away. So I think that's my full system. I hope you found that interesting. It's just what I came up with over the past couple years that I've been doing this. So it's been working well for me. So that's it. Robert, I hope you like this. I hope that answers your question. I think you need to tell us your process. So maybe you'll answer your own thread. So I'll leave a link below to the thread question from Robert. And I guess I'll put a link to all of the thread questions from Robert. And then if you want to go see my responses to those thread, I do have a playlist on my channel, thread questions, and they're inside of that playlist. So everyone, thanks for watching. Hope everyone's doing well. Really appreciate you all subbing and commenting on my videos. It does mean a lot, and it's much appreciated. So I'll have some more videos coming up soon. I hope you're all doing well. Everyone take care, and I'll talk to you again later.